Okay, that's the line. Let's see how this one sounds. I like this because it's two bars of the same chord. You get to kind of marinate a little longer. Oh, I like that change actually. Another one of those inverted chords. And another. Totally different flavor. Now, of course, I'm just playing exactly what's in the book. I'm playing the phrase, I'm moving through the chords, I'm doing the exercise. What I should make an example of is what else you can do with this stuff. Like, this is, as I'm playing it, I'm like, oh, I want to step outside, I want to take this somewhere else, I hear another melody. Absolutely, that's the next step. That's the thing you should be doing with it. After you're comfortable with the fact that you can stick in this one pentatonic framework, go in and out. We're using C minor again, we're playing over all these different chords. C minor, A flat, F minor 7, D flat major 7, B flat minor 7, A flat over C, D flat over F, F sus, F7 sus 4. But my next thing is, like, let's get out of here. I just mentioned that I want my melodic playing to feel a lot more honest and a lot more open and loose. So let's play a little bit. Let's get away from the line and play a little bit just on these changes. Shit, to be honest, I'm not a massive fan of the self-deprecating thing. I'm not doing it for effect. I'm just being completely honest. It doesn't feel relaxed or honest yet. That's just where I'm at with the process. Doesn't feel horrible. You know, it's okay. It's possible. If you heard it, you'd be like, oh, okay, dude knows what he's doing. He made the changes. He can play a little. But you're not really hearing anything phrasing-wise that's inspiring or particularly fresh or new or curious. I don't think I'm hearing or feeling curiosity. I think that's probably the key word there.